I'm Towns Van Zandt, and this is Guy Clark. We know one song together, so we're going to do it for get it over with. I was telling Guy earlier, it's a real pleasure to be the first people to play here. My favorite movie of all time was Conan the Barbarian. Well, it didn't work backstage and it didn't work here either. Well, this is called No Lonesome Tune.
Of this is we just kind of stand up here and trade songs and talk and tell stories, have as much fun as we possibly can. I was born out in West Texas in a little town called Monahans. It's out between Pecos and nowhere. Pretty desolate part of the country. And this is a song about the first time I ever saw a streamlined train. And it's just not... I don't know, but y'all have trains all the time, you know, but it's kind of... The United States, I kind of let them go downhill, I guess. Anyway, I'll never forget it. It was like a, you know, like a shuttle launch or a moonshot or something. And the whole town turned out. Train didn't stop or nothing. We all went down there anyway. I've been 6 years old. I had seen some trains before. So it's time to figure out what I'm at the depot. Trains are moving, laughing, smoking, steam, screaming at the wheels, bigger than anything is. At least that's the way she feels. Trains are big and black and smoking, louder than July 4th. But everybody's acting like this might be something more than just picking up the mail. The soldiers run to war. This is something that even old man Wildman never seen before. It's a late afternoon, a hot Texas day. Something strange is going on and we is all in the way. There's 50 or 60 people just sitting on their cars. And the old men left their dominoes and they come down from the bars. Ooh, and everybody's checking. Old Jack Kitchell check his watch. And us kids put our ears to the rails to hear him pop. So we already know that when he finally said train time, and you'd have thought that Jesus Christ himself was rolling down the line. Cause things got real quiet. Mama jerked me back. Not before I got the chance to lay a nickel on the track. Woo! Look out, here she comes, she's coming. Look out, there she goes, she's gone. Screaming straight through Texas like a mad dog. So big and red and silver, she don't make no smoke. She's a fast rolling streamline. Come show the folks. I said, look out, here she comes, she's coming. Look out, there she goes, she's gone. Screaming straight through Texas like a mad dog. So never even stopped. She left 50 or 60 people still sitting on the cars and they're wondering what is coming to me and how I got this far. Even me, I got a nickel smashed flatter than a dime by a mad dog, a runaway red silver streamline train. Look out, here she comes, she's coming. Look out, there she goes, she's gone. Screaming straight through Texas like a mad dog, slacking. Big and red and silver, she don't make no smoke. She's a fast rolling streamline. Come to show the folks. She said, look out, here she comes, she's coming. Look out, there she goes, she's gone. Screaming straight through Texas like a mad dog, slacking. Yeah. Look out, here she comes, she's coming. Look out, there she goes, she's gone. Screaming straight through Texas like a mad dog, slacking.
Well, drop the setting out of your ring. If Dave and Maureen are here, I want you guys to hold hands during this song. I needed you
some love. You will miss sunrise. You can close your eyes. That would break my heart in two.
Telling people lately that there's a line that song has been recorded a couple times. There's a line in there called "Goes Loop and Lil Agree," and every time it's been recorded, they've changed that line because it, you know, what does that mean? You know, Loop and Lil were parakeets that I hung out with. During, it's hard to own a parakeet, you know, but I hung out with them for when I wrote that song. They're roadkeets. They don't do too good on them. I mean, they covered more miles than your average parakeet.
One time, Towns came to pick me up at the airport. No, I went to pick him up. That's what it was. I was picking you up at the airport in Nashville. And I see him coming down the concourse, you know, and we're walking towards each other. Hey, man, what's going on? The closer we get, I notice his coat's going like. He's got those two parakeets, one in each inside pocket. They're traveling in space.
One time, I was on the airplane, and Loop was over here, and Lil was over here, and the stewardess came up and said, would you like a drink? And Loop said, cheap, cheap. And the stewardess says, no, they're not cheap. They're $3. Then, as long as we got into this little... What happened to him was I was in New York, and about on the fourth floor of a brownstone, and the window was open a little ways, and Loop and Lil were always loose, pretty much. And Loop, I guess, wanted to go back to Nashville or somewhere, and he flew out the window. It was December in New York, so it was adios, Loop. And then about... 4 or 5 days after that, Lil died from a little teeny broken parakeet heart.
Thank you.
sure to send a reason for that. Oh, Susanna, don't you cry, baby. Love's a gift that's surely handmade. We got something to be.
Apartment out in Los Angeles, damn, California. Pretty weird place. The weirdest thing about it, though, was the landlord. It was one of those guys who come home from work every day, go out to the garage, make his own bullets. Nice thing about this place, right outside the front window, it's the prettiest grapefruit tree you've ever seen in your whole life. Oh, the grapefruit were sweet. One morning, we awoke to the sound of that landlord out there with an axe. Chopping down the grapefruit tree. So I went outside and said, "Man, what are you doing?" He said, "Oh, guys, did you know this damned old grapefruit tree?" He said, "Somebody's just been here 30 or 40 years, I guess. He said, it's gotten so big, and the roots have spread out so far. Starting to crack my concrete patio. Back up, all your wishes. Make note of all good wishes. Say goodbye to the landlord for me. Get you all those bored me.
Song that I haven't recorded yet. It's about the homeless of the land. It's called Marie. Well, I stood in line and left my name. It took about 6 hours or so. It was all a game. Said they'd let me know. Put in my time till the Pocono line shut down 2 years ago. I was living at the mission till I met Marie. I can't stay there no more. Little fella across town said he's looking for a man. Find a burned out van, do a little settling down. I'm just dreaming, I ain't got no ride, and the junkyard's a pretty good ways. Job's about a half week old, besides, be gone now anyway. Unemployment says I got no more checks than they showed me to the hall. Died in Georgia some time ago. I got no one left to call. Well, summer wasn't bad below the bridge, a little short on food, that's all. Now I gotta get my Reese some kind of coat. We're headed down in the fall. I used to play the mouth harp pretty good. Hustle up a little dough. But I got drunk and I woke up rolled a couple of months ago. Really got my harp and they got my dollar, them low life so-and-so. Harps cost money and I ain't got it. It's my own fault, I suppose. Chesapeake's running 2 freights every day. It's just me, I'd be headed south, but Marie can't catch no train. She got some pain and she thinks it's a baby, said we gotta wait and see. In my heart I know it's a little boy, hope he don't end up like me. Said he lost my file, I gotta stand in line again. I wanna kill him, but I just say no. I had enough of that line, my friend. I head back to the bridge, it's getting kinda cold. I'm feeling too low down to lie. I guess I'll just tell Marie the truth. Hope she don't break down and cry.
Tangler. That's what you call that one. Great song. This is kind of a new song, too. About a year and a half ago, I was down in Austin, Texas for Jerry Jeff Walker's birthday bash. And we got bashed. And we bashed. And we had some fun. And I ran into a couple old friends of mine, crazy guys, one named Ramblin' Jack Elliott, some of y'all might have heard of. If you haven't, I'll tell you for sure, they don't call him Ramblin' Jack because he travels around a lot. If you've ever heard Jack tell a story, you know what I mean. And this other guy, maybe the world's best rodeo cowboy that ever lived. His name is Larry Mahan. He lives in Bandera, Texas, and like 10 times in a row world champion all around cowboy. Well, the three of us decided, well, I don't know if we decided, but we certainly proceeded to stay up all night to greet the dawn in Austin, Texas. So Ramblin' Jack said, I got these lines in my face, trying to straighten out the wrinkles in my life. When I think of all the fools I've been, it's a wonder that I've sailed this many miles. To which Mahan replied, he said, the sweet bird of youth sitting on my shoulder yesterday, but she's always changing partners, and I always knew she'd up and fly away. Just staying up all night in a Frisco motel, Ramblin' Jack and Mayhem cowboyed all to hell. And the room smelled like bulls, the words sounded like songs. Now there's a pair to draw, two boys I would not steer you wrong. Soul on fire just for show. Trying to think of all the fools I've been, it's a wonder that I've sailed this many miles. That's not right. He said, I recall a time set my soul on fire just for show.
Admired the British sense of humor and British courage, and also liked English pubs, you know. But I can't imagine why any country on earth would import Thunderbird wine. I mean, I've seen some over here. You can smell that stuff without taking the lid off, you know. This song, I've been doing this song a long time. It's the first talking blues I ever wrote. It's about the first time I ever had any Thunderbird wine. It was about 1965 till about 71. Yeah, among the strangest things I ever heard, this friend of mine said, "Man, let's get some Thunderbird." I said, "What's that?" He just started to grin, slobbered on his shirt, and his eyes got dim. He says, "You got 59 cents. I got a dollar, but don't be a smart aleck. I ain't gonna spend it on no Indian relic." He said, "Thunderbird's not an Indian trinket. It's a wine, man. You take it home and drink it." I said, "It don't sound like wine to me." He said he'd bet me the change from my dollar. We hustled on down the nearest Utotum. The guy wanted my ID. I whipped her out and showed him. He got a green bottle from the freezing vault. My friend started doing backwards somersaults through the cottage cheese. We took it back to his house, started drinking, and pretty soon I sat in to thinking. Man, this Thunderbird is yum, yum, yummy, and I know it's doing good things to my tummy, tummy, tummy. That's the way you reason when you're on that crap. Bottles and chugged them down. I pulled myself up off the ground. Decided I'd go see my dear sweet wife. She met me at the door with a carving knife. Said, "Get them damn grape peels from between your teeth. See, we're going to have a little misunderstanding." Said, "Dear, I better get in touch with you later." She said, "Forget it, man. You're never touching me again." I've heard the word, and I'm staying awake, my old Thunderbird. The message come from heaven, radiant and fine, and now all I drink is communion wine. 6 days a week. Tennessee joke. You can put this old body in prison, but you can't keep my face from breaking out. Yeah, I got to get out of Tennessee, man. Here's another kind of a talking blues of a different sort. This is about playing five-card stud poker, the gambling game, called Mr. Mud and Mr. Gold. It goes real fast, but the good guy wins in the end, barely. Thank you. did glow. Mud was leopard to sighs and trembles, watching his hard-earned money go. Blushes fell on gold like water. Chins they paired and paired again. The aces only flew through heaven. The diamond jack called no man friend. The diamond queen saw Mud's ordeal, began to think of her long-lost son. Fell to her knees with a mother's mercy, prayed to the angels, everyone. The diamond queen, she prayed and prayed, and the diamond angel filled Mud's hole. And the wicked king of clubs himself fell face down in front of gold. Three kings come to clubs' command, but the angels from the sky did ride. Three kings up in the streets of gold, three fireballs on the muddy side. The club queen heard her husband's call, the Lord and Queen of Diamonds joy. When the outlaw in the heavenly hall turned out to be her wandering boy. Mud he checked and gold bet all, and Mud he raised and gold did call. The smile just melted off his face when Mud turned over that diamond ace. Here's what this story's told. You feel like Mud, you'll end up gold. You feel like lost, you'll end up found. So amigo, lay them raises down.
Here's a real pretty song called Old Friends. Like when you're making conversation, and you're trying not to scream, and you're trying not to tell them that you don't care what they mean, and you're really feeling fragile, and you really can't get home, and you really feel abandoned, but you want to be alone. Begins to fade, and there's nothing to protect you except a window shade. It's hard to put your finger on the thing that scares you most. You can't tell the difference between an angel and a ghost. Oh, shine like diamonds. Oh, friend, you can always come. Here's another kind of new song. If you ever have one of those friends that thinks it's real funny just to get real drunk, call you up about 4 o'clock in the morning. Hey, man, how you doing? I'm just thinking about you. Wanted to call you up and say hi. I used to be that guy. Your mama, sorry about your pa, sorry about the business with your brother-in-law. Hard cheese about the money, man. Hard cheese about the stock. Hard cheese about your beer at the ears and high. Tough luck about your luggage, man. Tough luck about your socks. Tough luck about the way that the other shoe drops, yeah. I know about your girlfriend. I know about your wife. I know about the thing you call the rest of your life. Hey, how'd you get this number, man? Who do you think you're talking to? Who do you think you're killing? What do you want me to do? How'd you get this number? Please don't make me laugh. You know you ought to be on TV with a line like that. And I heard about the car wreck. I heard about the fight. I heard about the time you're in jail all night. I know you don't like trouble, man. I know you don't like to fight. But I know that you can argue with a fence post all night. And I heard about the lampshade. I heard you had it on your head. I heard you told a joke and knocked a hole in the bed, yeah. The cough syrup. I know about the junk. I know about you being a deep blue funk. How'd you get this number, man? Who do you think you're talking to? Who do you think you care? What do you want me to do? How'd you get this number, man? Please don't make me laugh. You know you ought to be on TV with a line like that. Thank you.
Thanks, you guys. Well, this is called Blaze's Blues, about my late friend Blaze Foley, but I figure old Blaze was late his whole life, so he's not, you know. He's just on a trip across the ocean. So I wrote this song. It's an interesting story. I ended up with his guitar, and I was playing it one morning and kind of playing his finger-picking style, and I made up some words about Blaze, and I was playing it his finger-picking style on his guitar, and the words were about him, so I decided, well, maybe it ought to be called Blaze's Blues. I almost called it Blue Blaze's, but I thought, he's probably the only guy that would have got it, and he's late. Thanks, everybody. There was this guy walks into this pub, and he's really well-dressed, nice-looking man, not a wino or anything. And bartender walks over, and he says, "Yes, please, I'd like 3 shots of gin." And the bartender says, "Okay." Gives him 3 shots of gin. And the guy real thoughtfully, you know, pensively drinks one, Thanks for mixing. After about 35, 40 minutes, he gets up, pays up, and leaves, and comes back after about 2 weeks, and the bartender kind of almost recognized him, you know, seen him before. He walks over, and the guy says, three shots of gin, and the bartender, that's right, mate, three shots of gin. And same thing. And he leaves, and about 3 weeks later, he comes back, and when he walks in, the bartender recognizes him, you know. He works, three shots of gin, right? The guy says, that's right, thanks. So, and the guy really calmly, deliberately drinks all three of them. He's getting up to leave, and the bartender says, hey, look, I kind of, you know, we kind of know one another. I'm curious, how come you get three shots of gin, you know, at a time instead of one shot of gin three times like most people get one shot of gin? He says, well, I have an older brother in Oslo, and I have a younger brother in Dublin. And we don't drink very much, but when we do, we always have, I have the first one for my older brother, and I have one for myself, and I have one for my younger brother. And whenever they have a drink, they do the same thing. And the bartender says, boy, that's a nice family tradition. That's great. That's great. So the guy, they say goodbye, and the guy leaves, and a couple, 3 weeks later, he comes back in, and the bartender sees him, and he's walking over to pour, and the guy's, two shots of gin. Oh, no. He pours his two shots of gin. The guy's slower than usual, you know, more pensive than usual. And he gets up to leave, and the bartender says, you know, I certainly don't mean to intrude, but I sure hope nothing happened to one of your brothers. He says, oh, no, they're fine. I quit drinking. Well, thank you. Thanks. I don't usually get applause for a joke. Thanks.
This is a song about a guy who's kind of like my grandfather. Actually, he's my grandmother's boyfriend. Where he was. He was a wildcatter out in West Texas. That means you drill oil wells just for the hell of it, you know. Doesn't really matter if you get anything. It's kind of a sport of it all. But anyway, he's the guy that taught me how to whittle and spit and cuss and drive a car and sit up straight. I play the Red Red Violin. He'd sit in the kitchen and cry, run his fingers through 7 years of living, and wonder, Lord, has every well I drill gone dry. From the time that I could walk, he'd take me with him.
domino. Oh, and they're lying by the lies while they play. I was just a kid. They all called his sidekick Desperado, waiting for a train. Like Desperado, waiting for a train. The one day I looked up, he's pushing 80. Stains all down his chin. Well, and he's one of the heroes of this country. So why is he all dressed up like them old men, drinking beer and playing moon in 42?
A lot of times people ask me what my favorite song of mine is, and this is always the answer. I'm not quite sure when, but it is. It's a song about 10 seconds in a woman's life.
She's standing on the gone side of the leaves. She found a thumb and stuck it in the breeze. She'll take anything that's going close to somewhere. She can lay it down and live it like she pleased. But she ain't going nowhere, she's just leaving. She ain't going nowhere, she can't breathe. She ain't second thoughts by the road. She's got feelings that need some repairing, and she did not give it there, that it showed.
When I bought it. That's one of the reasons I do all those songs in that D tuning at the same time, so I don't have to go through this but once.
Well, this is really a treat. I think Guy and I are going to play a couple more songs, and then probably be about 15-minute intermission, and then Peter Rowan will be here. And if you've never seen Peter, it's something. Then John Stewart, and then when after John plays for a while, Guy and I and Peter are all gonna join him. So I'm not exactly sure how he feels about that yet. When the four, I guess it's okay. It turns out we've warned him, you know. I mean, you signed up, here we come. Last night down in Romilly, we were having a bunch of fun, and Guy had decided John Stewart had played one too many songs, and backstage found a grocery cart, put that beautiful handmade guitar in it, and pushed it out on stage, and John was playing, and here comes a good and a very good push. It stopped like right there. This song is going to be Guy recorded this song once, and it's going to be on the Cowboy Junkies next album, which is, I think, coming out in December. Very nice folks, and some of y'all know them. To bear, where you've been is good and gone.
All you keep is the getting there. Well, your lips to fly low and high. So shake the dust off of your wings and sleep out of your eyes. It's goodbye to all my friends. It's time to go again. Here's to all the poetry and the picking down the line. I miss the system here. The bottom's low and the treble's clear. They don't pay to think too much on things you leave behind. Well, it may be gone, but it won't be long. I'll be bringing back the melody and the rhythm that I find. We all got holes to fill. Them holes are always real. Some fall on you like a storm. Sometimes you dig your own. Choice is yours to make. The time is yours to take. Some dive into the sea. Some toil upon the stone. But your lips to fly low and high. So shake the dust off of your wings and sleep out of your. Shake the dust off of your wings and the tears out of your eyes. We'll be back.
Yes, we will. Grocery cart? I pushed my guitar in a grocery cart?
Hard times, cotton mill girls, hard times.
I don't remember any of that.
Some guys have all the luck. Sing this verse. somewhere that true love conquers all. I figured that was that. And started having dreams about being chased out of town wearing nothing but my cowboy hat. But it's no deal. Can't sell that stuff to me. Oh, no deal. I'm headed back to Tennessee. Well, I come through this life a stumbler, friend. Expect to die that way. Could be 20 years from now. Could be most any day. But it ain't no whiskers.
Listen to this song. It's not supposed to be this serious.
I guess you're right.
Well,
but there ain't no whiskey and women, Lord, up behind them heavenly doors. Won't take much in. Thank the sound men, too. That was a nice job.
Thanks
this place is declared broken in. See you in a little while.
They can steal or borrow two nickels or a dime and call me on the phone. I will meet you at Alamo Mission. We can say our prayers. The Holy Ghost and the Virgin Mother will heal us as we kneel there. In the moonlight, in the midnight, in the moonlight, midnight, moonlight. In the moonlight, in the midnight, in the moonlight, midnight, moonlight. If you ever feel sorrow for the love you have wronged, with no hope for tomorrow in the setting of the sun, and the ocean is howling with dreams that might have been that last good morning sunrise will be the brightest you ever seen. In the moonlight, in the midnight, in the moonlight, midnight, moonlight. In the moonlight, in the midnight, in the moonlight, midnight, moonlight. Ay, 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 ay.
What a pleasure to be back in this beautiful city and see all my friends again. And to be here with Guy Clark, Towns Van Zandt, and John Stewart is a special honor for me. It's really, I can't tell you how thrilled I am to be part of this little tour and to be the christening the Barbican Caves. The Barbican Caverns, I like it. Sounds good, crisp. I can't wait to see what they do here. About a year ago, I did an album about America called Dust Bowl Children. And I'd like to play some songs from that album. This first one is about a character we see out across the wide open spaces of the American West. I call him Tumbleweed.
Far across the Mississippi, out on the open plains, in an Oklahoma cow town where the sky begins to rain. In a dusty, run-down honky-tonk sits a drifting tumbleweed. Thumbing through a magazine that he can't even read. Tumbleweed remembers how the West was won and lost. The Homestead Act and the Dust Bowl, everybody paid the cost. The great white father promised to treat his children all the same when Indian territory was Oklahoma's name. But Tumbleweed keeps rolling, he just roams from town to town. It ain't easy for a half-breed kid to try and settle down. Tumbleweed keeps rolling, he can't find no place to rest, 'cause the desert wind blows tumbleweed, the spirit of the West. His boot heels tapping time to an old flat top box guitar. He's a local guitar hero, Well, he sings straight from the heart, and his tip jar is a jumble of worn out dollar bills. He makes his bread and groceries in the local bar and grill. When he starts picking that old guitar, well, the people turn and stare. When he starts singing them songs he wrote, there's magic in the air. He can heal your wounded heart, he can set your spirit free. He can raise your hopes to be the very best that you can be. But Tumbleweed keeps rolling, he just roams from town to town. It ain't easy for a half-breed kid to try and settle down. Tumbleweed keeps rolling, he can't find no place to rest, 'cause the desert wind blows Tumbleweed, spirit of the west. So when you cross the Mississippi and you hit the open plains, you pass through Indian territory where the sky begins to rain, and you're feeling kind of rootless, you can't find no place to nest, just remember Tumbleweed, the spirit of the west. Oh, the desert wind blows Tumbleweed, spirit of the west. Yet the desert wind calls Tumbleweed, spirit of the west. Country girl way down in Tennessee. Daddy was a country boy, he swept her off her feet. She became a woman at the age of 17. Started out with nothing, no more than just a dream. Times were hard when they got started down there on the farm. They believed that working hard never did no harm. The seeds of hope were planted, the story is the same. We all know the crops won't grow if they don't get no rain. And the dust as fine as powder comes up between my toes, bringing back memories of a barefoot country road. The memories of a barefoot country road. Now the weeds have taken over where the wheat and corn once grew. Look here, I just found me this old rusty horseshoe. If it could talk, I know that it would tell a tale or two. The old ways die hard, make way for something new. And the dust as fine as powder comes up between my toes, bringing back memories of a barefoot country road. Oh, the memories of a barefoot country road. Got to do is sweat and pray and hope and dream. Ain't much change what I can see from where I stand today. You bust the sod, you trust in God, and you work night and day. And the dust as fine as powder comes up between my toes. Still standing on this barefoot country road. Oh, the memories of a barefoot country road. Mama was Hannah Mariah. Everything we owned got all burned up in the Great Depression fire. Strip mines and a one-crop farm and drained the green earth dry. We lost it all, the lonely love was left, love the one thing money can't buy. Yeah, we hoped just for children singing in a dust bowl. Dust just blows when the green fields are gone, when the green grass growing fields are gone, when the green fields are gone, when the green grass growing fields are gone. Hey, there's work of every kind. The only job I ever got out there was waiting on a welfare Once I had a dollar, once I had a dream. Now all the work is being done by a big old machine. Yeah, we hold up for children. Dust just blows when the green fields are gone, when the green grass growing fields are gone, when the green fields are gone, when the green grass growing fields are gone. Hey, hey. There's a bluegrass revival coming on. Let the green fields grow strong. There's a grassroots revolution coming on. Hey, hey. The seeds that my daddy sowed, these are the fields that my daddy hoed, these are the crops that blossomed in the field we grew from the seeds that my daddy sowed. This is the bank where the money goes to pay back the man that my daddy owed, who sold us the field where we harvest the crops that grew from the seeds that my daddy sowed.
I wrote most of these songs while I was living down in Nashville, Tennessee, and we were having a terrible drought down there. hadn't rained for about 2.5 years. It's a pretty scary thing to see. So one night, Elvis appeared to me. And he said, and I said, El. He said, Elvis to you. He said to me, I want you to write a rainmaking song. He told me to write a rainmaking song, and he expressly told me not to make a new age ditty out of it. And stay away from neo-shamanistic tendencies and write a good rockabilly rainmaking song. So I heeded the words of Elvis as he appeared to me in the vision. And I wrote this rainmaking song, and I sang it in Nashville, and it poured rain in Arkansas for about a month and a half. That's when I moved over to Blanco, Texas. It's dry in Blanco. I sang this song in Blanco, Texas, the center of the universe. It poured rain in Oklahoma. Floods everywhere. I had the timing right and the trajectory wrong. So I'm going to sing this song here tonight. I don't take any responsibility for what happens in this building. But I don't know if the clouds can gather. It's a mighty big ceiling up there. Sing along with me if you feel like it. This is a song. Probably rain in California tonight when we need it out there. So.
Rainmaker, the land is parched and dry. Rainmaker, rainmaker, make the rain fall from the sky. Rainmaker, rainmaker, the crops are gonna die. Rainmaker, rainmaker, make the heavens cry. When you try to make your living making rain, got to put on a real good show, tell the people anything. You got to get the Lord's attention any old way you can. Maybe he'll show a little mercy and start crying for the land. Rainmaker, rainmaker, the land is parched and dry. Crops are gonna die. Rainmaker, rainmaker, make the heavens cry. Well, some say I work miracles, some say I'm just insane. Many a time I bet my life that I could make it rain. One time I had a whole town beating drums and singing through the night. And we watch the morning sun come up with not a rain cloud in sight. I knew if I didn't make some weather and see them storm clouds gather, I'd be run out of town when the sun went down, covered up in tar and feathers. Well, I was on my knees and I raised my hands to the heavens high. I felt the rain like a sigh of relief come pouring from the sky. Rainmaker, the land is parched and dry. Rainmaker, rainmaker, make the rain fall from the sky. Rainmaker, rainmaker, the crops are gonna die. Rainmaker, rainmaker, make the heavens cry. Let the cool rain fall on down. Let the cool rain fall on down. Sometimes I don't know if it's a blessing or a curse. Too little rain is not enough, and too much just makes things worse. Well, the good Lord promised me a miracle in this life with only one condition. He said, take your money, get out of town, don't try and start another religion. Oh, rainmaker, rainmaker. where the land is parched and dry. Rainmaker, rainmaker, make the rain fall from the sky. Rainmaker, rainmaker, the crops are gonna die. Rainmaker, rainmaker, make the heavens cry. Rainmaker.
Yeah, just a little bit less guitar on the monitors. It's very, very loud. I don't like my playing that much. Excellent sound up here. Take it down just a little more, please. This is a tune that I've just recorded with a lady named Allison Krauss, a young bluegrass singer, plays a fiddle and got a beautiful voice. Love. the title song of the new one. It's a bluegrass album, kind of. Well, we take it as far as we can. And there's a little bit of reggae-billy on it and some other styles made up. Sam Bush and Jerry Douglas and Allison and Stuart Duncan. Roy Husky on the bass. This is the title tune. Sound in here is really amazing. I'm sort of getting used to it. It's Yeah. I'd like to take you out now into the southwest of the United States. To a mesa in southern Utah, overlooking the San Juan River snakebacks, if you've ever been out there. Overlooking Monument Valley. Well, 100 miles from nowhere, out on the desert sand, one eyed Jack the trader held some turquoise in his hand. And by his side sat Running Elk, his longtime Indian friend. He vowed that he would stay by Jack until the bitter end. Jack had gambled everything he owned to lead this wandering life. He might have had a happy home, tender loving wife, but his hunger was for trading trappers' furs for turquoise stone. Anything that the Indians had, Jack wanted for his own. Oh, the wind blows cold on the trail of the buffalo. Navajo, in the land of the Navajo. Said Jack to Running Elk, I'll gamble all my precious stones before I leave my body here among these bleaching bones. For now my time is drawing near and I'm filled with dark regret. My spirit longs to journey as the sun begins to set. But we've raped and killed, we stole your land, we ruled with guns and knives, fed whiskey to your warriors while we stole away your wives. Said Running Elk, what's done is done, you white men rule this land. So lay the cards face up and play your last broken-hearted hand. Trail of the buffalo. Oh, the wind blows cold in the land of the Navajo. In the land of the Navajo. River, Running Elk raised him the sky.
Jack saw him with the sun and moon and upped him with the stars. Running Elspeth, the Rocky Mountains, Jupiter and Mars. And the sun was sinking in the west when Jack threw the ace of spades. Running Elf just rolled his eyes, he smiled and passed away. Jack picked up his turquoise stones and cast them to the sky. He stared into the setting sun and he made a mournful cry. Oh, the wind blows cold on the trail of the buffalo. In the land of the Navajo. In the land of the Navajo. Thank you. How you doing? This is Dave Batty on my right, your left. Give him a nice hand, all the way from California. Are we in the right place? That's a little small for my taste, but I guess it'll do. So that was it, Dave? This is our big opening, too. The
showbiz excitement at its best.
I'm gonna use another chord.
Going to be okay, believe me. It's been an interesting experience being on the road with Tom. Being on the road with Towns, Van Zandt, and Guy Clark, and Peter. Towns is an amazing guy. I mean, they're all amazing guys, but Towns is really an amazing guy. As a songwriter, there are just no seams. You just can't see him writing. You can't see any tricks. It's just too honest, you know. I just wonder. You can't learn how to do that, you know. Either born with it or you just can't do it. He can do it. Dave, we got to swap chords here. So we'll be right with you here. I wonder if you too has this problem. I don't think so. So this is going to go, okay, pull that red one out there, will you? Don't try this at home. We are professionals. Okay, so this is going to go into the direct box. Get that off. Yeah, feeling better, love? Well, get that. Don't worry about it. Can you think of what this would be like if we had been drinking? Well, at least we'd have an excuse, right? That easy. Charging my unit up in the dressing room, see? And some smart, wise guy came along and flicked the power switch. So I came back and... But we'll go on with those fascinating stories a little later. But first, the music. We were living in a magic time. We were living with time to burn. Believing there's nowhere to go, believing we had nothing to learn. We had to pick time dreams, self-inflicted wounds, bullets in the hourglass, life on other moons. I will work for food, I will work for fame, I will work for money, I will work the game. What are you working for? Do you know the name? Don't kid yourself, they're not the same. Unchain the dogs, for I'm back again. Looking for Jack on the other side of the wind, and I can't seem to reach it with words in the wind. Yeah, and the moon's behind a cloud, and the night porters say the collective blessings get you through the day. A livable truce, Can we live that way? Promise of the crossing and the house stops sound. Yet a fine ground zero, you just look straight down and final crossing, waiting for the light. Lawyers on my lawn, another sleepless night. Unchain the dog. I'm looking for Jack on the other side of the wheel. Unchain the dogs. Oh, I'm back again. Just looking for Jack on the other side. Looking for Jack on the other side. Looking for Jack on the other side of the wheel. Never seen before, and are the choices for the sparrow, or to see only fly high above the rivers, yeah, pulling you and I across strange rivers. In the rivers that you cannot see, there are strange rivers, and they know our destiny, for there are strange rivers, and we're sailors, you and me. He could have been a builder, he could have been the one to turn his dreams to steel, yeah, cathedrals in the sun. And he could have been a builder, but then he bought the gun. There were forces in that river, yeah, that keep him on the run. For the vast strange rivers, rivers that you cannot see, for the vast strange rivers.
And they know our destiny for the Rough Strange River. The sailors you need. Did you ever turn the corner and you wondered why you did? You haven't been that way, no, since you were just a kid. And nothing really happened. But then you have to say that you wonder what would happen had you gone the other way. For there are strange rivers, rivers that you cannot see. There are strange rivers, and they know our destiny. For there are strange rivers. We're sailing, you and me.
Dying in the sun.
Thank you so very much. Is it true that we are living in the last days of the world? And often I wonder, will you always be my girl? Will you be my girl? And we'll dance the night away. We'll remember Elvis, yeah, and we'll dream of better days, and we'll listen for the sound, and we'll chew upon the lesson, we won't always be around, and you hear the sound, well, you'll always be my girl, and we can dance together, in the midnight of the world, of the world, yeah. In the midnight of the world, of the world, in the midnight of talking about the poison in the rain, and faceless corporations, who really are to blame, are they to blame? Yeah, we don't get along, so let's turn on the TV, pretend that nothing's wrong, it's like a song. She must always be my girl, and we can dance together, in the midnight of the world, of the world, yeah. In the midnight of the world. Everyone we've screwed, women, blacks, and Indians. It was on the evening news, on the evening news. And they had pictures at the scene, and I wonder among them would say their skirts are clean, but what I mean, say always be my girl, and we can dance together in the midnight of the world, of the world, yeah. In the midnight of the world, of the world. In the midnight of the world, of the world, take care. In the midnight of the world. And this time I should be thankful for all that I have got, instead of bitching and complaining of all that I have not, I just forgot. There are people with the blues, we're living on the sidewalk, and they're sleeping in their shoes, they are the clues. You must always be my girl, then we can dance together, in the midnight of the world, of the world, yeah. In the midnight of the world, of the world, yeah. In the midnight of the world, of the world, I'll say hey. In the midnight of the world, of the world, take care. In the midnight of the world. How many of you have an album I did called The Last Campaign? Anyone? Okay. That's enough. As long as one person has it, you know, God love it. There's an artist named Jamie Wyeth, whose father is Andrew Wyeth, whose father is N.C. Wyeth. And back in the early 70s, we were hanging out one night and decided to court the muses. I said I was going to write a song and he was going to do a sketch, and the sketch he did turned out to be the cover of the Willard album, and this is the song from that night. Huh. kind of loosely based on John Steinbeck's The Red Pony. I used to find him reading in the front room by the light, till his eyes grew weary and he closed them for the night. First he'd ask me questions, who I'd seen, where I'd been. Was I running with the renegades, looking for the wind? And every story that he told me was carved upon his brow. And he colored them with language, yeah, that Mom would not allow. And then he'd whisper softly, with that sly and evil grin, he'd say, "Are you running with the renegades, looking for the wind?" Now his empty corner bedroom, it still stands behind the door where I had gone to see him so many times before. You don't have to ask me where he's gone or where he's been. No, he's running with the renegades, just looking for the wind. Cody sang to me. It was a song about the great Montana sky. Cody sang to me, and I could see Montana in his eyes. And I could see Montana in his eyes. Cody's hair is long, and it's dirty as the rivers of L.A. Cody's mind is gone, and you never know just what he's gonna say. No, you never know just what he's gonna say. seems that those that have the secret in life are those who love doing things just for doing it and don't look for the rewards about it. Cross in your heart, you have blood on your hands, mud on your shoes, you are making a stand, and you are running the race, and your only prize is you. You found you a reason to rise, finding a reason to rise, and to carve out a face on a mountain of stone, day after day, one man alone. And it took 20 years just to get to his eyes. Ah, but he'd found him a reason to rise, finding a reason to rise. And you must realize that you're not telling lies if it's crazy, but it shines in your eyes. And you must realize that on a star in the sky, find the reason to rise, finding a reason to rise. Here's what you do when you give it your all. There's nowhere to run, and you're too weak to crawl, with the pain in your heart and tears in your eyes. It is, you find you a reason to rise, finding a reason to rise, finding the reason. Where the sun never shines, and we will go where the night bird only flies, and that's a long time, you know, for the kind of wind to blow. Long time ago, we were dreamers on the rise, and then twice we said we'd begin again, and we made a vow. Said that we'd remain as friends and fallen down. We said we shall rise again. And that's a long time, you know, for the kind of wind to blow. Long time ago, we were dreamers on the mend. Long time ago, we were dreamers on the mend.
Nice hand for Dave Battiano.
I'd like to say something on the part of cute food. We as a species, we as a race, tend not to eat cute food. Let me elaborate. Please do, someone said. We won't go home tonight and cook up the kitten. It just isn't done. In some cultures, like the Koreans, will eat anything. Boy, you walk down the street there, there's stuff hanging around that hasn't been alive for 40 years, you know? American Indians have a recipe for puppy. It's cruel. I admit it's cruel. I'm saying, is this one life form different than another life form? Is the lobster in the tank any different than the chicken? Question posed, perhaps not answered tonight. There's a story in an American magazine, cover me, about scientists who experiment on rats. And if the rat is in the cage, it's a good rat, and certain humane guidelines have to be followed, as minimal as they are, in experimenting on the rat. If the very same rat gets out of the cage, it's then a bad rat, and they can kill it any way they want. Sort of the way we look at each other. A song called Bad Rats. Good rats all have wheels, good rats all have names, good rats all can feel, good rats are the same. Good rats all have friends, good rats all can eat, and good rats all get papers to protect their little feet. A song about good rats. Bad rats have no friends, bad rats have disease, bad rats all must end, bad rats all must leave. Yeah, 'cause bad rats have no friends, and bad rats die alone. Let's all kill the bad rats and pass around the stone. Song about bad rats. Song about the good rats. If there ain't no way, no woe, telling us about a rat. Ain't no way, no woe, telling us about a rat. Is there any way that you know, telling us about a rat? Look at all them Asian people, glad they're not like me. Look at all them Ethiopian people, glad they're not like me. Look at all them homeless people, glad they're not like me. Look at all them Iraqi people, glad they're not like me. Song about the bad rats. Thank you. Here's a song from the California Bloodlines album. A song about the fact that all of us, I think, have this fantasy that out there on the highway somewhere, someone thinks we're terrific. I can't hold it on the road when you're sitting right beside me, then I'm drunk out of my mind. Hell, even the fact that you are here. And I have not been known as the saint of San Joaquin. Just as soon right now, pull on over to the side of the road and show you what I mean. La da 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 da, la da 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 da. But you lie, you more than anyone I've ever known.
that line out before me. When your hand is on my collar and you're talking in my ear. Yet I have been around with a gypsy girl named Shannon, daughter of the devil. Well, it is strange that I should mention that to you, 'cause I haven't thought of her in years. La da 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 da. Sitting right beside me, and I'm drunk out of my mind. Well, even the fact that you are here. And I have not been known to say to San Joaquin, and I just assume right now, pull on over to the side of the road and show you what I mean.
A new album out called Deep in the Neon. I'd like to do a song from that.
Yeah, I like it. What? It's now, it's today.
You will indulge me.
faithless hearts are sailing, blowing in the sails, believing is moving as if the wind fails. Oh, faithless hearts are sailing, blowing in the sails. Still I'm a believer in a mystery train. I am a receiver in the mark of Cain. Oh, I am a believer in the grace of rain. I'm a believer in the grace of rain. I'm a believer, I'm a believer, yeah, 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 in the grace of rain, in the grace of rain. And kiss me in the shadow, kiss me in the dark. Kiss for me the secret of the lovers of Hyde Park. Kiss for me the reason for a thousand sleepless nights. Kiss for me a lover out in the streets of Shadow Lane. Kiss for me a lover on the streets of Shadow Lane. The raindrops on the corner, the Columbia Hotel. Who hides in the shadows of the lips that never tell? Night was made for lovers, of a lovers made for night. Kiss to me a lover on the streets of Shadow Lane. Kiss to me a lover on the streets of Shadow Lane. For all of my life I've been dealing with a knife. All of my life I've been dealing with a knife. Over and over again, like the blade of a knife. All of my life I've been dealing with a knife. All of my life I've been dealing with a knife. Over and over again, like the blade of a knife. Dealing with the night, dealing with the
cheer up.
first wrote this song. The second verse was, you once thought of me as a white knight on his steed. Now you know how funky I can be. And this, of course, refers to the day after the wedding of the homecoming queen and the daydream believer, when the last toaster has been opened and they're laying in bed in the morning looking at each other with the breath of doom. That's where love is defined. When the monkey sang it, he sang, now you know how happy I can be. And I said to the producer, I said, Chip, Davey just sang, now you know how happy I can be. That doesn't make any sense. Chip said, the record company won't let Davey sing funky. This is way pre-live, two live crew. And this is back when the monkeys were the Piltdown Man of New Kids on the Block. About 3 months later, it was number one around the world, and I said, Chip, Happy's working real good for me on this right now. You once thought of me as a white knight on his steed, but now you know how funky I can be. And a good time start and end without dollar one spent. But how much, baby, do we really need? Everybody sing it with cheer up, sleepy dream. For oh, what can it mean to a daydream believer and a homecoming queen? Cheer up, sleepy Jean. For oh, what can it mean to a daydream believer and a homecoming queen? A homecoming queen. Thank you very much. Dave Batty. Thank you. Good night.
my woman to the hairdresser. This is what the hairdresser said. I can't help your woman's hair, man. Maybe I can help her head. You're buying rats all the time. Peter came in and started us on that blues song. That wasn't part of the plan.
It's a love song.
Kind of a love thing.
There ain't nothing in the world I like better than bacon and lettuce and homegrown tomatoes. Up in the morning, out in the garden, get you a ripe one, don't get a hard one. Plant them in the spring, eat them in the summer, all winter without them, culinary bummer. I forget all about the sweating and digging. Every time I go out and pick me a bigger. Homegrown tomatoes, homegrown tomatoes. Wouldn't life be without homegrown tomatoes? Only two things that money can't buy. And that's true love and homegrown tomatoes. Go out to eat, and that's for sure. But it's nothing a homegrown tomato won't cure. Put them in a salad, put them in a stew. You can make your very own tomato juice. You can eat them with eggs, eat them with gravy, eat them with beans, spent over navy. Put them on the side, put them in the middle. Put a homegrown tomato on a hot cake grill. Homegrown tomato, homegrown tomato. What'll life be without homegrown tomatoes? Only two things money can buy, and that's true love and homegrown tomatoes.
Here we go.
This is a classic song by our friend Peter Rowan, and it's in the key of C, the people's key. It's called the Free Mexican Air Force.
Flying so high, high, high.
smoke from their six-shooters spinning their barrels for fun. Contrabandista, bandidos of life. We're the free Mexican Air Force and we're flying. The law wants it all cause they think that the wild weed can free you. Freedom for us is a prison for the rulers of mind. That's why the free Mexican Air Force, come on. Thank you. Hey, town.
I was expecting to be a grandfather, you know. I have a son that's 22 years old, and he's been with this lovely young lady down in Texas for a couple of years, and they obviously care for one another a great deal. And I sit around the house and think, you know, I could be a granddad. And I was going to get me a rocking chair and a cane, you know. Anything alive came around me, I was going to whap it on the forehead and tell it, get away from me, I'm a grandfather. I don't have nothing to do with that. And all of a sudden, the news comes down the pike that instead of being a granddad, I'm going to be a father again. So I thought about dyeing my hair white and telling the kid, I'm your grandfather. That's your mother over there. I don't do diapers. I don't do food. You know, you're old enough to take to a ball game, we'll go. Up until then, just leave me alone. And that's kind of pretty much how I feel. Well, the news is out all over town. She been seen out running round. I know that I should leave, but then I just can't go. You win. Heart of mine could never see what everybody knew but me. Just trust in you was my great sin. What can I do? Thank you.
have no shame. You take true love and give the blame. But I know that I should not complain. I love you still. I love you still. You win again. I'm headed out on the highway, listen to the big trucks whine. White red line, won't you steal away my mind? Well, New Mexico ain't bad, Lord. People there, they treat you fine. New Mexico ain't bad, Lord. People there, they treat you fine.
Lord. Towns Van Zandt.
Thanks, you guys. That was a pleasure. Thanks. This is a nice new place.